had a water, big water bill, and that was helped out. I had a food stamp situation. I had no food.
State of Florida ranks 41st in the country in health outcomes. Out of the 67 counties in our state, we're 61st in health outcomes.
When I was asked to open up a new medical school for the state of Florida, I thought it would be a wonderful opportunity to embed the medical school in the community.
Greater than 120 community organizations participate in the program. We pretty much have a very strong representation across all sectors.
It gives people the opportunity to get these resources near where they live.
I think FIU is on the right course by trying to target some of these things that we think are more upstream. We welcome that opportunity to kind of change the conversation away from patients being non-compliant, not taking their medications, to actually making a household visit and realizing what it is that's actually taking place in that household.
You identify things that, you know, the patient would like to work with and skills that you would like to develop, and between the two of you, you sort of embark on this journey where you're both learning and you're both helping each other.
See you again.
You
Mrs.
too.
Davies.
So
How
glad to see you. Good, good, good.
I think that this has definitely opened up my eyes to see all aspects of taking care of a patient, not just at the bedside.
For me, it's allowed me to grow in that I look at the patient more holistically.
She had a water issue with her utility bills, so the law clinic started helping her out with that. They actually got an agreement in place with her, which she follows through all the time, and she's doing great with.
Another goal that we're trying to meet is Medicare. She's already 65, so she's eligible for it. So I'm working with her to choose a plan that is best for her.
The patient's health is much more determined by the other factors, the access, the economics, the education, the health literacy. When we first met her, she was having her stroke, she didn't have running water, she was wheezing, and in 1 year of work, we addressed pretty much all the important things that you need.
Now they come to clinic and you have the one up on that. You know that there's probably something in their life that is totally unrelated to care, that is hindering their ability to get better.
It's one thing to treat someone with a medication because they're depressed, but if the real problem is that they don't have a job, then being able to work with them on that is an ability to actually solve the real problem.
If there's some problem that looks systemic in the communities, we will then prioritize it for policy work.
We saw something like 60% of the households were using ER as their usual source of care beforehand, and it dropped like in half.
Mobile Health Center was specifically designed to provide free primary care services to households without insurance in the Neighborhood Health Program. We provide vaccinations, we do pelvic exams, pap smears, we do blood work.
Works perfect for me because I'm working and I do it between jobs.
We've actually saved the state of Florida money. That is, for every dollar they gave us, we returned $6.
I had high cholesterol and high blood pressure. And thank God, I always say when I go see Dr. Anderson and Lorraine that they saved my life.
1 year, somebody as sick as Ms. Davis in the normal circumstances would have been admitted several times and abused the emergency room several times.
Works great for me and for my family.
We've seen that with our first and second graduating class, a progressively increasing number of our students that go into primary care specialties. This last year was 60%.